The burden of pertussis in the first years of life is huge, and the problem now is that infants are at risk of complications, but that pertussis is not only present in the population of children, but also in young adults and in parents of young infants. So this means that it is extremely important to maintain protection throughout life, because it has been demonstrated that the protection induced by the disease itself, but also by vaccination, usually lasts around 5 years. At the end, in many countries, the national plans have included the first schedule of pertussis vaccination in the first year of life, a booster at the age of 5 to 6 years, another booster in adolescence, and then a 10-year booster, so a booster every 10 years, that is extremely important to maintain the protection in the population. Apart from this, another category at risk is represented by the pregnant women, because different systems have been tested in the years, the cocooning strategy with the vaccination of the household members of the newborn, but this strategy does not work too well, because there are always some people that have not been vaccinated. In addition, the vaccination of the neonates, but was not so effective. Whereas there are several data now showing the efficacy and safety of the vaccination on the pregnant women in the second and third trimester of pregnancy. These data have demonstrated the efficacy, that is higher than 90%, against pertussis in the neonates and infants in the first 6 months, and the fact that when the infants receive the regular vaccination in the first months of life, there is not any significant interference with the production of antibodies. The point is that now probably we have new methods for the diagnosis of pertussis, and we are informed also of the fact that pertussis is frequent in the different age groups. And for this reason, there are documents on which WAidid, for example, has worked that highlight the system that should be used for pertussis diagnosis in hospital during endemic but also during epidemic period. Secondly, results on the immune response against the vaccine have shown the need of boosters that should be repeated throughout life. And in addition, now there are interesting data on new strains of Bordetella pertussis, for example, those that are pertactin negative, that seem to circulate, or on hypervirulent strains that require surveillance, again highlighting that in infectious diseases, prevention is extremely important, but surveillance is important too.